Hello guys, I'm Laszlo. Welcome back to the sixth... Three, two, one. Action. Hello guys, I'm Laszlo. 3, 2, 1. Action. Hello guys, I'm Laszlo and welcome back to the fifth episode of my Britannia campaign playthrough. Last time, we have unified the northern part of Britannia. We confederated with Artois and Lyonnais, and we have also captured Mousseillon. Now we are going to move against the Crooked Moon, because they are gaining ground and threatening Karaknorn. Then I will going to help out the Empire in their fight against the Vampire Counts. If they are at war, no, but they will be at war very soon with them. So this is it. Let's see how are we doing diplomacy-wise. So we have Bastogne. They want to join our confederation. We will confederate them. And we are in a negative income again. Perfect.
Protector of the realm.
Let's just get rid of these units quickly. Bastogne and Montfort are one province. And let's see, what can we build here? Do we have any special buildings? No, we do not have anything. So, like, this is almost the central part of Britannia. So I'm thinking that I will have some buildings that have regional effects. I will build up this one, because it reduces vampiric and chaos corruption, and I think I will build up a brothel here too. Is there anything else? No. This will be a simple economic city, nothing special. I don't know if we have anything in Montfort, I cannot check it yet. Can I? Nope, I cannot. So, let's start with building a Greal Shrine. And I will keep these for the time being. Maybe could, no. Alright.
Warrior King.
Let's see, what else do we have here? Bordello. Oh, we can trade with Pavarum. And we can have a military alliance with them, which we will sign. How about Bordello?
Welcome, friends.
Nothing.
Let's hope we come to an accommodation.
And Carcassonne, we have already signed everything with them. Can we trade with anyone else? I can trade with the border princes.
Deliver your message.
That's nice. They hate me. Oh, in the coming turns. They're at war with the Crooked Moon and with the Bloody Hands. So by fighting the Crooked Moon, we will gain some extra diplomatic points.
King Lewin.
Let's see, can we get anything here in Marienburg? Marienburg will level up in a lot of turns, so it's not that important to improve it right now. And for Korun, we have 2 turns until we can upgrade it to max level, Duchy Capital. But nothing too interesting here. Alright.
I have seen your heart.
That's me saying. Alright, I think I will end the turn. We have 4 more places for peasants, so I will recruit here a few more peasants and I will release these knights, this army.
Do you know who I am?
Because they have a decent peasant line. The upkeep will be quite high for these knight errants. I don't know if it's a good idea. You will see. Well, yes, and I can issue a commandment. My public order is quite low, so I will have the public order for the time being. Let's see, in Marienburg we have the growth, alright? In Korun we have this. And the growth here too. Everything seems fine. Let's end the turn. Do you like my new camera angle, by the way? I think it's much better this way. Wow! We were too late. Karaknorn has fallen. It makes me sad. Well, there's nothing we can do about it. What peace negotiated with Empire Towns and Talabakland. I hope the counts will be contained until I can deal with them. Let's see. What can we recruit? So, here.
I will see it
now. We are in a hurry against the Crooked Moon.
Guardian, it shall be so.
Let's exchange units. So I will give you 1, 2, 3 units of cavalry.
Sallying for.
I lost some income, but that was to be expected, and I will recruit some peasant bowmen. Can I have a special bowman here? No. Alright. We cannot recruit the box arrow bowmen right now. We have two new building slots here. That's great news.
By the light of the lady.
So, Luan Leonker. You will have some spearmen at arms. And one more peasant bowman.
Who calls?
And for Masson du Ali. Dear Masson. I will disband these.
Yes.
And recruit men at arms instead of them. Man at arms. So man at arms. With pole arms. They have charge defense, armor piercing. I don't need armor piercing. I will have man at arms. Spear man at arms. Quite useless too.
Noble.
You know what? Let's have two pole arms version man at arms. So, we have some money. Let's build things. In Lyonnais. Lyonnais will be my cavalry recruitment province, so I will have the Warhorse Breeder stables and the stables built up. And we are running out of money already. Can't upgrade here, here. One more turn I can, until I can build this, but I won't have the money. Oh, and I can recruit the Green Knight one time. Alright. We will keep him for emergencies. And in 2 turns I will move against the Crooked Moon. They are at war with almost everyone around them. Except with the Wood Elves. I don't know why. Carcassonne is at war with the Wood Elves. Power is fine. Bordeaux is fine too. Let's end the turn here. The Wonkarsteins are moving into the Empire territory. Talabakland and Ostland are at war. What are the Wonkarsteins doing? They are at war with Karakhern and the Beastman. What? Did I see that right? Oh no, I thought that the Beastmen had positive relationship with the Wood Elves. Alright, they might be chasing the Beastman, Isabella von Karstein. So, Luan Leonker's army is ready, so I will move here with him for the time being. And I need a turn or two to get ready. They have 2 stacks and a bog.
Let me think about it.
And I have 2 stacks too. Against
my
them.
Strength and wisdom are yours.
It'll be fun. I hope so. Right now we are researching the heraldry of Carcassonne, then we will try and confederate with Carcassonne. And after that we'll confederate with the middle section of Bretonnia. Bretonnia shall be unified. Although I could start researching the greenskin technology, because I am going to spy the greenskins for some time, Oh, they have moved against the Empire, I believe. Or Visanland. One stack and Borgami, I will ask. Visanland. No, I don't need anything from them. But I will try to establish a trade agreement. I cannot. It's unfortunate. Let's move my armies.
Lord of Guatonia.
The Grand Crusade against the filthy Greenskins commences finally. So if I move here, they will be able to attack me with two armies. So I will just move here somewhere and maybe ambush. Oh, just move here. Wait for the other army to catch up. I have now enough population surplus and I don't need the growth bonus here. So I will increase my tax rate. Here I need 6 more turns and yeah. Kinda this is it for this turn. I'm quite curious what the Greenskins are planning near Grumberg. They might be besieging it. Chaos stirs. Storm clouds gather in the north. There are rumors that the barbarous tribes residing in the shadow of chaos has seen striving against each other. Alright. Norska might be activating. Not the best news for me. Why do I have minus public open? Yes, let's see why. Well, that's unfortunate, but what can you do?
King Lewin.
The Greenskins are besieging Grumberg. Are they? Yes, it seems they are. And they have a full stack here. Can I save Grumberg? No, I cannot. Best. Best case scenario is that I move here.
Strike
both of my armies. And next turn I will be able to move on Grumberg and head them out. If it's not destroyed by the time. So finally Musigon has been upgraded, or I can wait one turn and upgrade Kurun to maximum level. I think I will do this because gives me the most income in the long term. Marienburg has some basic walls. Nothing too exciting. Can I trade with the border princes finally?
Deliver your message.
Yes, please, no. Fine. So if chaos attacks,
you ask for a boon.
Join war against the Wood Elves? No, thank you. If chaos attacks, then has been attacked by Estalia. Obviously, I will enter. Braveheart's come. That's cool. Miss Travels and I, by happenstance, stumbled upon a statue of the lady, forged of solid gold. Many in the court suggest we bring it back to the city as a monument, but locals near the forest say it protects them from dark forces. What shall we do? We could trade. Take it, and it will inspire the people or protect its citizens. Plus protection and leadership for infantry. I think I will go with the protection. In the long term, I think it's just better. So, where did the Greenskins move? There is a Beastman army here. Oh, here they are. Can I attack them?
My reputation precedes me.
No, I cannot. But I can move here and block their escape back to the mountains. I will even set up an ambush here.
Unwell! Strength and honor!
The lady calls.
With one of my armies in this army.
A wise move.
Armored in faith.
Oh, I cannot upgrade them because I found it up. That is so in Kurun, finally we can upgrade our capital. Trade agreement, non-aggression pact, everything is broken with Stalia. I will ask my allies to join.
You come bearing arms.
The war against Carcassonne. How many turns? One turn. So next turn I will confederate them anyway. And then I will make peace with Stalia. It seems like the greenskins have been captured. And an ambush. Skarsnik got himself into an ambush. Ain't that nice? My reinforcement will come from the north, but I think they will be irrelevant in the long term. I will place this trebuchet on this hill so I can fire on the enemy. This is Skarsnik. So, my melee line will crush with their infantry units. I will deploy them like this. This is they are the battle pieces. What can they? They have frenzy, blessing of the lady, and they can hide in forest. It's everybody else. Nothing too exciting.
Battle pilgrims.
This will be my deployment. They are what? Arachnor spider. I did not see that. Then I will redeploy my units a bit differently. Like this. So on the left side flank will be my battle pilgrims, and here will be my two spearmen who will take care of the Arachnid spider. And then my archers here. My archers will prioritize on the enemy ranged cavalry. Then my cavalry will attack from this front, from the forest. Let's see, what are my anti-large units? These are anti-large, these are anti-infantry, and anti-large too. Alright. They will hide here, they will attack the spider and these units. And this cavalry will charge right into the enemy lines. Everyone who can deploy into this formation, and well, my Pegasus Knights will help anywhere they are needed, I guess. The Greer Reliquary, I have not seen this unit up close. Beautiful. So, this will be supporting my infantry line. What does it give? Leadership, Frenzy, Blessing of the Lady. Magical resistance, missile resistance, alright. So it can actually be used in combat a little bit. And King Luan will be here to tie up Skarsnik if he comes into the battle. Yeah, this will be it. This will be army number one, so I can differentiate between my two armies. It's time to charge into the enemy lines. Fire on the Goblin Wolf Riders. So, these will charge into here. Questing Knights into the enemy infantry. Two sides, and these two units will attack the Spider, and these two will go against the enemy cavalry, and I will adjust my lines from here. Everybody's doing something. It's perfect. And I will cast a Wind Blast, Curse of the Midnight Wind, as soon as the engagement starts. slow things down. My reinforcements are approaching. Alright. It's unfortunate they managed to wrap around me. Let's send them here. So, this flank will need my help. These units will retreat now. Let's break the formation. Just come here as soon as possible, alright? Let's cast Curse of the Midnight Wind now. Here. I will charge with my cavalry into this. Luan! Into the fight, man! We'll just chill out. Let the reinforcement come here as soon as possible. The Arachnarch Spider is losing the battle, but my cavalry is kinda useless there. Let's chase these goblin archers. My... Into the crate, people. Where is Luan? Let's activate everything. Let's take out. Support these units. And I don't know. What should you do? Run on standard. Let's buff these spearmen times up. The enemy has been defeated. Minimal losses. Just hurry here. Start here. Can I even do anything? Yes. Luan, kill these. The goblins are not routed completely. Let's see. I don't want any of my units in this formation at this moment. Can I cast? That is actually useful. Broken too. This questing is not doing too great. I don't need to move. This casting could just die. And we have victory. Let's chase them down. I don't want them to retreat. I should not kill Skarsnik because they will have a new lord. Alright. Let's leave Skarsnik. And I think we should kill this spider. Spiders are not healthy. Not healthy to leave them alive. Just chase something down. Oh, goblins are dead. This was a fast engagement. Ended in a few minutes. Luckily for us. Let's speed this up. Wrap every loose end up. Let's chase something. They're just arriving. Alright, that's enough. Decisive victory. So, decisive victory. We will execute the captives. Because we don't want the minor chivalry. They're moving in. Assassinate my lord. I hope they fail. I'm surprised that the Empire did not attack. So, then again, block army success, heraldry of Carcassonne. Foolish vainglory. Well, obviously we want the boar favor. We are at war. So, what do we have? Red Horn Tribe was encountered. Wow, great. We're moving a full stack against Castle Carcassonne.
You seek the lady.
And the Fey Enchantress is in their way.
Do you know who I am?
My paladin gained rank. Upgrade the Foe Seeker. Is there anything else I can do? Not really.
Something wrong with your aid.
I can attack Carcassonne. What are these Bordello people doing? So, what technology should I research next? I think I will go with the the Green Tide. Green Mountain Search. And this one. So, I think this will be it for this episode. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. See you tomorrow. Bye!